Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Bioscience Guide. Today the topic is pituitary gland of human being. The structure of pituitary gland is small in size, pea-like in structure, and about 500 mg in weight and reddish gray in color. Pituitary gland is found at the diencephalon, situated at the base of brain. Pituitary gland is known as master gland because it produces hormone which control the functioning of other endocrine glands. Pituitary gland consists of three parts: anterior lobe, middle lobe, and posterior lobe. The anterior lobe is also known as pars distalis. It is formed by an outgrowth and consists a network of blood vessels. Middle lobe, it is known as pars media. It is formed by downgrowth at the base of brain and it is found in between anterior and posterior pituitary glands. The posterior lobe, which is known as pars nervosa. The anterior and middle lobe of the pituitary gland form together called adenohypophysis. It is the non-nervous part of the pituitary gland. It is about 75% part of the pituitary gland. The post lobe, which form the neurohypophysis, it is the nervous part of the gland and it is about 25% part of the pituitary glands. Adenohypophysis secretes about 6 different hormones: thyroid stimulating hormone, adrenocorticotropin hormone, gonadotropic hormone, prolactin, growth stimulating hormone, and melanocyte stimulating hormone. Thyroid stimulating hormone or thyrotropin, it stimulates thyroid gland to secrete T3 triiodothyronin and T4 tetraiodothyronin. Adrenocorticotropin hormone, the adrenocorticotropin hormone stimulates the adrenal cortex to secrete adrenocorticosteroid hormones. The adrenal cortex secretes 30 steroid hormones. Gonadotropic hormone, the follicle stimulating hormone, stimulates the development and maturation of ovarian follicles to produce eggs. It also stimulates the development of seminiferous tubules for spermatogenesis. Luteinizing hormone that stimulates ovulation and formation of corpus luteum for secretion of progesterone and estrogen hormone. It also stimulates for the secretion of testosterone. Prolactin, it is also known as lactogenic hormone. It stimulates lactation in pregnant women and it also promotes the growth of tissue in breast. Growth stimulating hormone or somatotropin hormone, it stimulates the growth and division of body cell. Melanocyte stimulating hormone, it stimulates the pigmentation of skin of body. It is also responsible for the growth and development of melanocytes. Disorder of growth stimulating hormones. The disorders are as below: dwarfism, gigantism, acromegaly, and Siemens disease. Dwarfism, it is caused by hyposecretion of growth stimulating hormone. Dwarfism, in which a person who has a smaller body size and bones which are short and sexually immaturity. Gigantism, it is caused by hypersecretion of growth stimulating hormone. Gigantism, in which a person with extraordinary growth in height and limbs are extraordinarily long. acromegaly. It is caused by the hypersecretion of growth stimulating hormone. It is an abnormal growth of feet, hands and face, looks like gorilla. Siemens disease. It is caused by hyposecretion of growth stimulating hormone. Person seems to be older than his actual age in adult stage. Hormones of neurohypophysis. The posterior part of pituitary gland is called neurohypophysis. It produces two hormones, oxytocin hormone and vasopressin hormone. Oxytocin hormone, it promotes the uterine muscle contraction during childbirth in pregnant woman, so-called birth hormone. It also stimulates the ejection of milk by mammary gland just before childbirth, so-called milk ejection hormone. In male, the oxytocin hormone helps in transport the sperm and its ejection. Vasopressin or antidiuretic hormone. The antidiuretic hormone decreases the water loss from kidney by increasing water absorption from distal convoluted tubule and collecting duct of nephron. The antidiuretic hormone also increases the contraction of wall of blood vessels to increase the blood pressure. The disorders of antidiuretic hormones are diabetes, insipidus, and antidiuresis. Diabetes insipidus, it is due to hyposecretion of antidiuretic hormone. It causes the excretion of abnormal large amount of water in urine. It is also called diuresis. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to my channel Bioscience Guide to stay updated with our more educational free content on biology. Antidiuresis, it is due to hypersecretion of antidiuretic hormones. It causes the excretion of a small amount of water in urine. Thank you for watching.